Hello viewers and welcome to Healthy Wrinkles YouTube channel once again. As you're aware, this channel is devoted to getting best of the healthcare information for senior citizens and their caregivers and family members. So we are not only getting experts from various medical therapy areas, but also we are getting experts from other support services areas and paramedics like home healthcare, like physiotherapy, like instruments and diagnostic, and so on and so forth. So idea is that provide you with the latest information and what are the services are available around so that the care given for the senior citizens and also that takes care of burden of which the family members sometimes they feel. So that's the purpose of Healthy Wrinkles. And I take the opportunity to welcome Mr. Prasad Bhide from RG Care for this session. And we are going to have a conversation with him for the next 15 minutes. Prior to that, welcome Mr. Bhide.
Thank you.
Prior to that, I will take probably a couple of minutes to introduce him and also the kind of pioneering work that he's doing at RG Care. So Mr. Prasad Bhide is a social entrepreneur who is passionate and dedicated to make a difference in services for patients as well as senior citizens especially. And he comes from a very different background, not from a healthcare background, but 15 years of diverse IT experience in India, US, and a few other countries. And definitely we'll find out from him then how did he get into RG Care. That's a question definitely we are going to have conversation around. Prasad founded this, Mumbai is the first professional home health service, if I use the word, called as RG Care. And then they are among the first ones to offer respite care, rehab, daycare centers for seniors in Mumbai. More when we talk with him as we move forward. But I'd like to just show you some of the glimpses of the work that RG Care, which they define themselves as the redefining care for elders, the kind of work that they're doing. And I think numbers they speak, about the big picture that they provide more than 40,000 days of services each year. So multiple patients, multiple locations, and multiple service providers. Also, I think which is very, very important is that they have trained more than 2,000 persons now for patient care, for the first aid, and especially with the focus on the care for the senior citizens. I think this is very, very important because you always have a dearth or the scarcity of right kind of, people, those who can offer the patient care or especially for senior citizens. So a great job which is being done for Mr. Bhide and RG Care on both the sides for managing patients and providing them service, as well as, helping hundreds and thousands of people to get trained and also probably get self-employed. It's an honor, I would say, that they were awarded in 2016 at the hands of Honorary Union Minister Harshvardhan, the best home healthcare service provider. Also won several other awards among top 100 social entrepreneurs across India, top 3 for Sankalp Awards, and so on and so forth. So the list is endless, but I think the kind of work that they're doing, and I'm sure the kind of blessings that they must be getting from seniors, from patients and their caregivers and family members would be immense. So I'm going to now start questions, and battery of questions for Mr. Bhide, and we have time over 20 minutes, and I'm trying to get maximum out of him in those 20 minutes. So first obvious question, Mr. Bhide, is what is this concept of RG Care and why this name RG Care? And especially given that your background is very different, so that's quite surprising. So if you can throw some light on that.
So I am an engineer by profession. I have worked in IT field for nearly 15 years. And all during working in the IT field, I always wanted to do something which will impact people's lives. And I was looking for something where I can make a difference, but I couldn't find that for quite some years. Once what happened, I was in US on one of the project, IT project, and my mother got hospitalized here in Mumbai. So I had to travel back here. And post her hospitalization, doctor told us that she will be bedridden for next 3 months. And I had to rush back to US again within next 2 weeks time. So then I started looking out for a help because I am the only son. There is no sibling that I have. My father also was aged. So we had a big challenge that time managing the care. So I remember visiting a couple of nursing bureaus that we have currently in Mumbai, and I was not very satisfied. And after few days, when I went back to US, I used to do a daily coordination with these bureaus. You know, sometimes people will not turn up or will come 1 hour, 2 hour late. And things were not professionally managed. And I have seen the people who were coming not having the basic knowledge, right? They didn't knew anything about first aid. They didn't knew how to take care of bed sores. And which made my mother's suffering, you know, much higher. And it took more than what she could have recovered. So instead of 3 months, it took more than 4 or 5 months. But I also felt sad about the people who are working because nobody was training them. So how could they deliver the best care, right? Because one part is about compassion. Second part is about skill. Compassion can be inherent, but you need to learn skills. And if you don't have, I think you can cause more harm to the person. And I remember we had very similar situation when my grandmother was also ill. During her last days for almost 2 months, my mother and my aunt, Sumasi, they both of them used to look after my grandmother. In Marathi, we call her Aji. So again, I remember that we had similar issue that time as well. And my mother and my Masi both had, you know, caregivers because it was too much of work. She had mental health issues as well towards the end. So it was very, very difficult. And we used to stay in one BHK. So managing that within that, and you require continuous care, doctor visit. So I thought this seems to be a very unorganized sector. And, you know, if I could do thing in this field, it will impact people's lives. So when I was in US, I thought, let me learn. So I didn't mind understand how things are done in US. I came back here. I did a 6 month research. People who are providing care at home, whether it is for seniors or patients. So I decided to come up with a training program. That's how IG Care was born. The idea was to train people to become a professional caregiver so they could take care of seniors and patients at home, whether it is a post-hospitalization care or any terminal illness. It is very important that, because that avoids a lot of hospitalization. If the care is taken properly at home, it avoids a lot of hospitalizations, expense, as well as the pain that families go through. That is why it is important as age of the people is growing, right?
Right.
The nuclear family concept is growing. So more and more people are going to spend their life at home. How do we make it better? How do we improve the quality of care? That was the whole intent of starting IG Care. So initial 1 or 2 years, we spent only on training people, creating content, creating material, creating awareness. Initially, people used to ask me why we need this training. We are anyway doing the job. Nobody's asking. There we have to show them the numbers, how their work actually causing some of the troubles because they are not trained. Suppose somebody gets a heart attack and if you don't know how to give CPR, you know, you will not be able to save life. If you don't know how to take care of bed sore, what bed sore? These are basic things. We teach a lot of other advanced things as well, but people were not doing even basic hygiene as well, right? So that was the whole intent with which we started IG Care. Idea of IG Care was to train people, give them skills so that they can take care of seniors and patients at home and improve the quality of life for the seniors. But at the same time, working with them, I have realized that it is also important to create dignified jobs. I don't want to create labor. We want to create dignified jobs or rather career. I also don't use word jobs. It should be career. It should be a long-term career. And if we are able to do that, then only we will be able to attract the good talent in this industry. This will be one of the fastest growing industry. This is one of the need of the hour for the society. And the need is only going to increase, right? India is still a young country, but as in 2050, if you look at the numbers, you know, they are huge, right? And we don't have that kind of a manpower. So I think we require to create careers as well.
One of the questions, you know, sort of I had is, while you know, care in your centers is one aspect, and senior citizens. But also, I think I understand that you offer a service which is sort of between hospital stay and home stay, something in between that, you know, after post-surgery or post-event, in the recovery phase, people can spend time and, you know, and then go back home. So what's that concept? And can you give a little more, you know, information about that?
So when we were working at home care, while working with a lot of families, we realized there are certain kind of illness, like Alzheimer's dementia or hip bone fractures, cancers. These are difficult to manage at home. And people suggested, why don't we start a center? So I actually wanted to start a daycare. I started with a daycare. It did not work so much. But when we converted that into a residential care center, I think it got full within 3 months, right? And we started this in Powai in 2017. The idea of that center has evolved over a time. Initially when we started, the idea was to look after dementia care. But as we evolved, the center is focusing on two aspects. One is geriatric care and second is palliative care. So geriatric, what does the geriatric care means, right? The aim of the geriatric care is to improve the quality of life for the seniors. And we have to keep them independent as much as possible, right? These are the two key criteria which geriatric care focus on, which will involve obviously a lot of paramedical, medical, and caregivers. But the focus is not any cure. The focus is to improve the quality of life. And we can do through multiple ways. And second is palliative care. Palliative care means what? There are a lot of terminal illness which don't have a cure. So we need to address the pain as well as the improve the quality of care, whether it is a cancer, whether it is dementia. In both the cases, you require palliative care. Can we add a spiritual care in that? So these are the two aspects that we are focusing. And under that big umbrella, we do multiple things. So one can be a daycare center for dementia patients where a senior citizen comes in the morning and goes back in the evening. Obviously, during the COVID time, we can't do that. Previous to that, we used to do. Second thing is what you mentioned is providing a rehab for certain orthopedic condition, whether it is a knee replacement, hip replacement, where they continuously need a medical support, paramedical support, whether it is a physiotherapy, occupational therapy, nursing, round-the-clock caregivers care, doctor visit. Now, all that managing at home can be difficult, as well as the rehab time required may get elongated and might require another hospitalization. So rather, if they bring it to us, you know, they can get recovered and go independent back to home based on their condition, maybe 1, 2, 3 months kind of a time, right? So that is a stopgap arrangement that we do for when somebody gets discharged from a hospital and before they really go back home where they are independent on their own, they can come to our center. And that is something we do for certain orthopedic conditions we currently do, and that can get extended to a lot of other conditions as well. We also provide short-term care, you know, when somebody wants to go out of city or out of country and their parents are single, they're not sure where to leave them. They can't leave them only on one caregiver in certain conditions. Then they can place them at our center as well. Also, we provide long-term care. You know, there are people who are staying with us for last 2 to 3 years. My vision is to have, currently we run two such centers. One is in Mumbai in Andheri and second is in Thane. We plan to have additional 32 centers in next 5 years. That's a big vision, but I think that is the kind of a need that we see.
Yeah. One last question I have is, you know, you talked about the care being offered at your centers. Also probably there is a need of a home care center, you know, so, and then since you are training so many, you know, staff and then sort of, you know, creating that talent pool, how yes. about offering the services at home? So do you also do that? And whether you know, can caregivers and family members depend on you for that?
Yes, absolutely. So caregivers is the something heart of the AjiCare. So that is something we have been doing from day one. So along with training, we provide services for 12 hours and 24 hours in Mumbai and Thane. These caregivers have been trained for at least 3 months to look after patients. We also have tied with various national skill development institutes. Also, we have our own training institute, which is accredited by NSDC. So we provide two kind of services at home. One is providing caregivers for 12 hours and 24 hours to look after elderly or patients at home. And second is we provide intellectual companionship. What does that mean is we provide sessions for seniors who are suffering from depression, who are having Alzheimer's dementia, or who are having Parkinson. Our clinical psychologist goes to their home and conduct 2 to 3 hour session. And these are very customized session based on their background, where they're liking. We do their assessment evaluation based on their MMI score. We create customized sessions for them to engage them in a meaningful way, as well as we involve family to train them how to look after them where they are involved, so their condition doesn't deteriorate further, right? We should be able to keep them engaged. We need to keep them engaged in a very meaningful way, something which will of their interest, so that whatever conditions that they are going through, we should be able to improve the quality of life. So these are the two services. One is the caregivers and second is the intellectual companionship, something that we are offering currently in Mumbai and Thane, which we want to expand to other 5 cities in coming years.
Right, right. And maybe with, I don't know whether it's possible, from a virtual consultation now has become a norm in COVID. Maybe probably can be expanded virtually to even other cities as well. I don't know. Probably that's a possibility that you should.
Yes, we want to do a work in geriatric clinic. We started that recently with Dr. Prem from Jaslok Hospital. So that, again, that is something now senior citizens have started accepting that. Earlier, it was very big no. They wanted to do a physical visit. But I think now they both the parties have started to explore that opportunity.
Right.
So I think that's a really good thing because it saves a lot of traveling, waiting time for both the things, right? I think so it's a win-win situation, especially the consultation for doctors can be done online. I see a lot of people accepting that, and we want to do a geriatric virtual clinic. That is something we will focus on in coming years.
Great, great set of services at your premises as well as at home. And I think one distinction that I see, I mean, there could be number of bureaus per se, but I think one distinction is that the kind of training and evaluation that you're doing for your people, I think it is something really wonderful. Just one last question. I mean, you talked about 2,000 people. Where do they get employed, or where do they go? I mean, I'm sure you must be employing most of them at your place or maybe in the home care. But otherwise, do they go out and then they serve others, or what does it happen?
Recently, we have started AjiCare Sevak Foundation, which is going to solely focus on the skill training. The idea is to provide this trained manpower. Obviously, one is to AjiCare, but also to other old age homes. We see that other old age homes also do not have a quality of manpower. You will see that they work with Aya Maushis who are not been trained by anybody, right? So you will see same kind of a suffering at those old age homes as well. So our focus is to provide the quality of good candidates to these old age homes, because hospitals are anyway getting that, or they train their people. They get nurses, they have training. But if you look at old age homes, they don't have. So that is the arrangement that we do. So beyond AjiCare, we put them to different old age homes. We have a tie-up with certain old age homes where we connect them. And if they're interested, they can start working at those old age homes. And some of the people do work independently as well.
Right.
But our difference is that we also have a technology platform which helps connect between caregivers as well as the clients. And the kind of metrics that we have, the kind of management team we have, I think it adds a lot of value. But the options we give to a lot of caregivers that they can either work with AjiCare, they can run independently, or they can go and work with various old age homes near where they stay.
Wonderful, Mr. Bide, and it was a great conversation, and wish you all the great luck and success for the initiatives and also the expansion plans that you're talking about. I'm sure it is going to help a lot of senior citizens, their family members, and also caregivers on the other side. So thanks for your time and wonderful.
Thank you so much. I wish everybody watching this a very, very happy new year.
Thank you. Okay.